Why do the heathen rage, and the people imagine a vain thing? The kings of the earth set themselves, and the rulers take counsel together against the Lord and against his anointed, saying, Let us break their bands asunder and cast away their cords from us. He that sitteth in the heaven shall laugh. The Lord shall have them in derision. Then shall he speak unto them in his wrath and vex them in his sore displeasure. Yet have I set my king upon my holy hill of Zion.
Israelites, it is important to know how to identify the characters in the scriptures. You must know who the heathens are. The kingdom of darkness love to group multiple bloodlines into one to better control the people. It is extremely important to know the difference between the word Gentile and heathen in the scriptures. The kingdom of darkness uses the seed of the fallen to insert words into the scriptures to cause confusion. The Most High is not the author of confusion.
But God is not the author of confusion, but of peace, as in all churches of the saints.
The spirit of confusion is meant to cause chaos. Where there is chaos, the people will never get to the root of a problem nor find a solution. The beast system and mainstream media specialize in distracting the people with chaos. They will spin a story multiple times to get the people to conform to their perspective. Satan uses the same strategy in religion. The kingdom of darkness will indoctrinate the people with multiple doctrines of devils to cause confusion. Black people are indoctrinated with numerous doctrines of devils via the Christian church. When the truth is being revealed to set them free, Black people reject their freedom to remain in bondage through religion. It is impossible to learn truth in organized religion because the truth is not being taught in religion. You will remain a bondman and bondwoman in religion. The scriptures reveal the truth would make you free.
And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
The Holy Spirit reveal truth and tell you the things to come. Israelites, it is important to not grieve the Spirit of the Most High. The Holy Spirit speaks to you daily. Obey the voice of the Most High to begin to understand the world you live in. The awakening is not exempt from foul, unclean spirits causing chaos. The same situation that is happening in religion is taking place in the awakening. Many Israelites are confused by the doctrines of devils from the disciples of Satan. No matter how many times the doctrines of devils are proven to be false, many Israelites cannot accept the truth. They continue to pass along the doctrines of devils to spread confusion in the awakening. The reason it is difficult for many Israelites to stop submitting to demonic doctrines, the doctrines of devils have penetrated their spirit and taken root in the flesh of the unrepented Israelite. Only the Most High can open their eyes to see. Remember, Satan aimed to please your flesh. If the spirit of confusion is permitted to dwell among us in the awakening, the spirit of confusion will continue to destroy lives and cause chaos everywhere it goes. The Most High is not the author of confusion. If you are confused, rebuke the spirit of confusion by engaging in spiritual warfare. Ignoring unclean spirits that are plaguing our communities is not going to stop the evil seeds from spreading. We must do our part to stop spreading confusion. If the Most High did not reveal nor confirm what you have heard, do not go around spreading the unverified doctrines or gossip. The beast system plants the seeds, and many Israelites water the poisonous seed by adding to it and passing it around. The spirit of confusion travels with the spirit of division and with many other unclean spirits. The scriptures reveal where there is division, a nation or household cannot stand.
And Jesus knew their thoughts, and said unto them, Every kingdom divided against itself is brought to desolation, and every city or house divided against itself shall not stand.
The indigenous Black people all over the world are divided. Due to the spirit of division destroying our communities, the serpent seed continues to rule over the indigenous Black people. The scriptures reveal Could two walk together unless they agree?
Can two walk together except they be agreed?
Black people have a history of making their enemies their allies. Through poor leadership and rebellion towards the Most High, their enemies continue to destroy them and their communities.
And I will set my face against you, and ye shall be slain before your enemies. They that hate you shall reign over you, and ye shall flee when none pursueth you.
Unity brings power as well as help from the Most High. Many words were inserted into the scriptures to cause confusion. The kingdom of darkness used the Council of Nicaea to alter the scriptures to their liking. As we continue to elevate in our spiritual journey, we must properly identify the characters in the scriptures. In addition, recognize the alterations. We must not let the alterations become a stumbling block to us. The Most High is revealing truth to all that have an ear to hear. So far, the Most High has unmasked the idol, Jesus Christ, that had a stronghold on his people. The Most High revealed the identity of the seed of the fallen. The Most High is revealing many truths, just as the scriptures indicate that in the last days, knowledge would increase.
But thou, O Daniel, shut up the words and seal the book, even to the time of the end. Many shall run to and fro, and knowledge shall be increased.
We are elevating spiritually. Because we are growing, we must leave behind childish ways and the beast system's programming. The beast system does not glorify the Most High. Everything that comes from the beast system is meant to destroy your relationship with the Most High. In addition, uplifting lawlessness to allow Satan to rule. Satan's multicultural propaganda is the easiest way the kingdom of darkness control various bloodlines. For example, the kingdom of darkness gathered tares from various countries in North Africa, Europe, and America, placed them in a nation they stole. They called that nation Israel. We all know the chosen people, the Israelites, came from one family, one bloodline. The illegitimate state form in 1948 is not supported by the Hebrew scriptures. Because the seed of the fallen control the beast system with their father Satan, the workers of iniquity enforced to establish the abominable state called Israel. The tares that were gathered to dwell in the land of Israel are practicing a religion called Judaism. Through Judaism, the kingdom of darkness controlled the people who have taken the identity of the Israelites. Satan has established various religious faiths to rule over the people. Under the umbrella of religion, Satan controls the world. The Most High does not operate like the world operates. The Most High deal with bloodline. Bloodline is a family clan. When the Most High identified the earth inhabitants, he looks at their bloodline. The Most High does not label his creation as a black woman or black man. The Most High identified me as his daughter who descend from the Israelite bloodline from the tribe of Judah. The Most High does not view a person by race nor appearance. Identifying yourself by race strips you of your inheritance, bloodline, history, and identity. If I identify myself with the black woman label bestowed upon me by the beast system, how would that separate me from the other black women from different bloodlines? Identifying as black is vague. When you accept their label, you give your enemies power to control your identity and image. Every year, our name changed. We were once labeled colored, black, Negro, now African American. The beast system has placed biracial people and mixed people into the black race. The beast system does not separate a person with one black parent with a person with two black parents. The indigenous people who place pale skin on a pedestal do not realize they are helping their enemies erase themselves. They gladly help the kingdom of darkness destroy their community by submitting to the lust of the flesh. The indigenous people who actively participate in whiting out his or her seed with no regards of the consequences, they are no different from the seed of the fallen who have stolen black history and imitate black culture. A person's religious belief does not identify his or her bloodline or race. The beast system convinced the masses that Judaism is a race. Because many people believe this deception, the kingdom of darkness can separate the Ashkenazi Jews from Caucasian people. The beast system successfully passed the imposters as the descendants of the Israelites because of their religion, Judaism. The beast system wants you to believe there is a difference between the Ashkenazi Jews from Eurasia and Caucasian people from Eurasia. There is no difference between the two. If we use the beast system race classification to identify the Jewish people and the white people from the same area, both groups stem from the Caucasian race. Israelites, the reason it is important for you to know who the heathens are, the workers of iniquity, group the heathens with the Gentiles in the scriptures. The word heathen and Gentile are not the same. Heathen is another name for pagans. I often use the word heathen to identify the people who do not serve the Elohim of Israel. A heathen is an idolater. The heathens are also the people the scriptures refer to as the wicked. People from all bloodlines can be a heathen. Most people automatically associate heathen with the serpent seed. Israelites, there are indigenous black people who are heathens. The Canaanites were heathens. Mizraim, Egypt were also heathens. They worshiped many gods. Isaac forbid his sons to marry the Canaanite women because of their many abominations.
When Esau saw that Isaac had blessed Jacob and sent him away to Padan Aram, to take him a wife from thence, and that as he blessed him, he gave him a charge, saying, Thou shalt not take a wife of the daughters of Canaan, and that Jacob obeyed his father and his mother, and was gone to Padan Aram. And Esau, seeing that the daughters of Canaan pleased not Isaac his father, then went Esau unto Ishmael, and took unto the wives which he had Mahalath, the daughter of Ishmael, Abraham's son, the sister of Nebajoth, to be his wife.
The Canaanites were a cursed people. The Most High did not want to use the Canaanite women to produce the Israelite bloodline. Therefore, Rebekah and Isaac encouraged Jacob to seek a wife from his mother's side of the family.
And Isaac called Jacob, and blessed him, and charged him, and said unto him, Thou shalt not take a wife of the daughters of Canaan. Arise, go to Padan Aram, to the house of Bethuel thy mother's father, and take thee a wife from thence of the daughters of Laban, thy mother's brother.
Gentile means a person who is not an Israelite. Gentile also defined as nations. Israelites, be careful with the word Gentile in the scriptures because, depending on the verse, it could identify several groups of people. In some scriptures, the word Gentile is used to speak to the Israelites. In other scriptures, the word Gentile is used when it referenced the heathens. The scriptures describe Japheth's descendants as Gentiles. Japheth's descendants are the only bloodline the scriptures associate the word Gentile in the book of Genesis chapter 10 as non-Israelites.
But these were the isles of the Gentiles divided in their lands, everyone after his tongue, after their families, in their nations.
Anyone can be a Gentile when it is defined as nation, including the Israelites. If you dissect Genesis chapter 10, verse 5, the word Gentile is used in the context of non-Israelites. By these were the isles of the Gentiles, non-Israelites, divided in their land after their families in their nations. Gentile is another word to describe non-Israelites. Just as we are Israelites and there are many other names that identify the Israelite bloodline, Israel, Zion, Ephraim, children of Israel, and more. The New Testament is when the word Gentile changed from non-Israelite to nations. The kingdom of darkness had the Council of Nicaea alter the scriptures to their liking. The New Testament is when a major shift took place. The focus changed from the Israelites to the nations or Gentiles. The Most High said the Israelites are the only family he knows.
You only have I known of all the families of the earth. Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities.
The Bible is predominantly speaking to the Israelites. The scriptures are revealing prophecy, how the Most High will redeem his people, and the judgment that awaits the heathens. You can see the major changes that took place in the New Testament. The scriptures are centered around the Israelites, the only family the Most High know in the Old Testament. In the New Testament, the Most High disregard his people to save the world. The kingdom of darkness used the word Gentile to give the scriptures a new meaning. Paul is known as the disciple sent to the Gentiles in the New Testament. Paul said in the scriptures he would go to the Gentiles since the southern kingdom of Israel, Judah, refused to believe.
And when they opposed themselves and blasphemed, he shook his raiment and said unto them, Your blood be upon your own heads. I am clean. From henceforth I will go unto the Gentiles.
In the New Testament, the word Jew can identify the southern kingdom of Judah or the entire 12 tribes of Israel. It depends on the verse and its context. When Paul said he will go to the Gentiles since the Jews refused to believe in Jesus.
And when Silas and Timotheus were come from Macedonia, Paul was pressed in the spirit and testified to the Jews that Jesus was Christ.
The Jews, verse 5 in Acts 18, speak of was the southern kingdom of Judah. At the time, Paul was not speaking to the entire 12 tribes of Israel. Paul used the word Gentile in the context of nation. The nations Paul was going to teach about Yeshua was the northern kingdom of Israel. Remember, the nation of Israel was split into two kingdoms by the Most High.
Wherefore the Lord said unto Solomon, For as much as this is done of thee, and thou hast not kept my covenant and my statutes, which I have commanded thee, I will surely rend the kingdom from thee, and will give it to thy servants. Thus saith the Lord, Ye shall not go up, nor fight against your brethren the children of Israel. Return every man to his house, for this thing is from me. They hearken therefore to the word of the Lord, and return to depart according to the word of the Lord.
The serpent seed wants to make it appear as if Paul was going to all nations since the Israelites rejected the Messiah. That is false. Paul was from the tribe of Benjamin, which means he was from the southern kingdom of Judah. Why would he go to the Canaanites or the Romans to speak about a Messiah that was sent to deliver the Israelites from bondage? The Israelites were servants to the heathens they live among. Why would teaching about the Messiah be good news to the heathens who wants to maintain control over their slaves? The kingdom of darkness used Acts 18 verse 6 as the foundation for religion. Satan used the grafted in doctrine to get many people to accept religion. Satan wants the world to believe Paul was speaking to all people to get the entire world to bow down and worship him in religion. If you look around, that is exactly what the people who are trapping religion are doing, worshiping the false Messiah, posing to be God in the flesh.
For thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven, I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High.
Israelites, the heathens are the indigenous black people that comes from all nations or bloodline who practice idolatry. The beast system wants you to believe the word heathen is a derogatory name. It is not. Heathen is another name for a pagan or idolater. Not everyone who say they serve the Elohim of Israel truly serve the Most High. The scriptures say they serve me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me.
This people draweth nigh unto me with their mouth, and honoreth me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. But in vain they do worship me, teaching for doctrines the commandments of men.
There are people in this generation who proudly boast of not believing in the Elohim of Israel. Their unbelief drives them to serve other gods. If everyone served the Elohim of Israel, there would be no need for religion and the various faith we have today. The beast system wants you to believe everyone is worshiping the Elohim of Israel in religion. The beast system is trying to combine all faith into one and create one God for everyone to bow down and worship. The scriptures reveal in Revelations that this will come to pass. Anyone who do not worship the image of the beast will be killed.
And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed.
Presently, the beast system is pushing for a one world order, one currency, one faith, one God. If you disagree, you will be killed. There are many people who do not serve the Elohim of Israel. The scriptures have a name for them, heathen. Everyone who do not believe or serve the Elohim of Israel would be a heathen. The New Testaments refer to them as Gentiles in some scriptures. Our ancestors were exiled out of the promised land for following the customs of the heathens. Our ancestors were led astray by following the heathens. They worship and serve idols which provoke the Most High, the Elohim of Israel, to anger. The Most High chastises people for following the heathens they live among.
And the children of Israel dwelt among the Canaanites, Hittites, and Amorites, and Perizzites, and Hivites, and Jebusites. And they took their daughters to be their wives, and gave their daughters to their sons, and served their gods. And the children of Israel did evil in the sight of the Lord, and forgot the Lord their God, and served Balaam and the groves. Therefore the anger of the Lord was hot against Israel, and he sold them into the hand of Shushan Rishathaim, king of Mesopotamia. And the children of Israel served Shushan Rishathaim 8 years.
The people's unbelief in the Elohim of Israel should not be a surprise to you. The scriptures speak about the enemies of the Most High and the abominations the heathens are practicing. The Israelites participated in the abominations as well. That is why we are in the land of our captivity, and the people that hate us rule over us.
And I will set my face against you, and ye shall be slain before your enemies. They that hate you shall reign over you, and ye shall flee when none pursueth you.
The idols of the heathens we read of in the scriptures are still here until this day. Baal, Dagon, Molech, Ashtoreth, and the others, they have new names in this generation. Unfortunately, many Israelites are still worshiping these idols.
For Solomon went after Ashtoreth, the goddess of the Zidonians, and after Milcom, the abomination of the Ammonites.
The heathens disguise their idols through religion. Israelites, it is important for you to understand that the Gentiles have their own God they worship and serve. The Most High selected the Israelites to be His people. Yah did not select everyone in the world to be His people. The Most High selected the Israelite bloodline that came from Jacob, who descend from Abraham and Isaac. Yah did not choose Jacob's bloodline because they were great people with power. Yah chose the Israelites because they were few in numbers.
The Lord did not set His love upon you, nor choose you, because ye were more in number than any people, for ye were the fewest of all people.
The people the world accepts as the descendants of the Israelites, their lifestyle is contrary to the life the scripture said would be the fate of the chosen people. The story of the Israelites is about one family. It is time that the Gentiles all over the world understand and accept this truth. The Israelite bloodline is not multicultural like the beast system is pushing. The Most High became a father and a God to the Israelites. The kingdom of darkness used the customs and traditions of the Israelites as the blueprint for religion. The Bible is the history and traditions of a family, the Israelites.
And I will take you to me for a people, and I will be to you a God. And ye shall know that I am the Lord your God, which bringeth you out from under the burdens of the Egyptians. And ye shall be my people, and I will be your God.
The kingdom of darkness altered the scriptures to gain control of the world via religion. Yah did not exclude non-Israelites who wants to serve and abide by His statutes and commandments. The non-Israelites are the indigenous dark people made in the image of the Most High. The Gentiles who believe and serve the Elohim of Israel are strangers. The strangers are not spiritual Israel who were grafted in. There is no need for the strangers to be grafted in. The scripture said the strangers would cleave to His people, the Israelites, just as the strangers who live among the Israelites have done in the past.
For the Lord will have mercy on Jacob and will yet choose Israel and set them in their own land. And the stranger shall be joined with them, and they shall cleave to the house of Jacob.
Do not let the confusion the kingdom of darkness inserted into the scriptures gain a stronghold in your life. A heathen is a person who do not serve the Elohim of Israel. A Gentile is a non-Israelite or nation. Do not study the scriptures independently of the Holy Spirit. You must have the Holy Spirit to reveal the truth of the scriptures to you. Whatever was taken out or altered, the Holy Spirit can fill in the blank and reveal the true context of the scriptures. Israelites, it is important to listen to the Spirit of the Most High. Do not let words such as heathen or Gentile cause you to stumble. That is Satan's goal when he altered the scriptures to confuse you. The scripture said you must study to show yourself approved. Israelites, remember, you can study to gain knowledge. However, the Most High is the one that will give you understanding.
For the Lord giveth wisdom. Out of his mouth cometh knowledge and understanding. He layeth up sound wisdom for the righteous. He is a buckler to them that walk uprightly. He keepeth the paths of judgment and preserveth the way of his saints. Then shalt thou understand righteousness and judgment and equity, yea, every good path. When wisdom entereth into thine heart, and knowledge is pleasant unto thy soul, discretion shall preserve thee, understanding shall keep thee.